Today I will show you my late electronic lead screw external upgrades for my ALS type 1, and I have made this also compatible with James Claw 42 default version and firmware. The ALS is the replacement for the transmission mechanical gears. Newly added necessary features to complete the ALS are automatic switching between ALS and CNC, end stops, fault warnings. You can now add all upgrade functions on your older model ALS from my ALS MLC or from Claw 42, and it works on his firmware. The system contains the ALS module with a scratch resistant transparent sheet, a rotary encoder, a 5 volt micro USB power supply, isolated stepper driver modules for open loop or closed loop, and the stepper motor or a servo. This is my late electronic lead screw, in short ALS. On the right side, I have a connector micro USB for programming and the dip switches for external power supply from the USB. But when programmed, it should be switched off. On the left side, I have connection for the rotary encoder that goes over here with the demo gear on top. In the middle, I have the connection for motor signals that goes to the upgrade for switching between CNC and ALS, for end stop signals that goes into here, and fault detection from the motor, and then the signals are going to the stepper motor driver that can be open loop, closed loop, or for closed loop servos using a bipolar motor or a servo motor. I'll now demonstrate the end stop function, that is this LED. On the bottom there are two dip switches. On the downward position they are enabled, upwards they are disabled. The first one is for this button to enable the spindle button. The second is a tailstock end stop button, that is this one. When they are not enabled, I can push on this one and on this one, but the end stop LED won't light. Also, when I'm turning the motor will turn, the rotary encoder will turn, and the end stop won't work because it is not enabled. So I'm turning and pushing the button and nothing happens. But when I'm enabling both, or one of them, and then rotate the rotary encoder and then push the button, the motor will stop. Like this. On the other side, the same. Like this. When I'm disabling one of them, the tailstock, and the spindle is just on the on position, I can now rotate this one. This one will stop, but this won't stop. But there's no beep because the sensor I've made, that is in one of my previous videos, end stops, has its own beeper inside, and that's an ultrasonar end stop beeper. The fault function is working as follows. When I'm turning the rotary encoder, the stepper motor is turning also. When I'm going up with the spindle speed or with the pitch that is a higher value, I will have a faster moving stepper motor, and when it's going too fast, it will beep, and also the blue light is going on. Then you know you have to lower the RPM or lower the pitch value. Motor selection is based on criteria like lathe dimension type, micro lathe, mini lathe, professional lathe, open loop or closed loop, bipolar stepper or hybrid servo, motor torque that mainly depends on motor's dimensions, name a 17, 23, 34, spindle speed with lower RPM results in accurate work even as open loop, while high RPM can result in too late step even with closed loop. Higher pitch settings results in faster motor speeds. Next time I will show you my programmable ultrasonar and stop sensor for my rotary head controller, CNC MLC and the lathe electronic lead screw.